Hello everyone, I am Deeta Sharma, working as an assistant professor in RPIT Medical and Technical Campus. Today, my topic is properties of matrix multiplication. In the last lecture, we have completed the topic matrix multiplication. But here, we will do the next properties of the matrix multiplication. Let us start. The first property is when A matrix multiplied to B plus C matrix. When A matrix multiply to B plus C matrix, then this is equal to AB plus AC matrix. Means first we multiply A to B matrix and A to C matrix, and then we add both of them, then these are equal. Means A into B plus C is equal to AB plus AC matrix. This is the distributive property. In the second case, A plus B matrix. First we add the A and B matrix, and then the resulting matrix, when we multiply this by C matrix, then this is equal to AC matrix plus BC matrix. AC matrix plus BC matrix, and then the resulting matrix, when we combine them by adding, then these both matrix will be equal. This is also called the distributive property. These first and second are the distributive property here. Next is A, B into C. Means when we multiply A and B matrix and then the resulting matrix multiply by the C matrix, these matrix is equal to the first we multiply B and C matrix, and then the resulting matrix when we multiply by A matrix, then both matrix will be same. And this is called the associative property here. Okay? Next, fourth property is the multiplication of matrix is not always commutative. Look at here, the multiplication of matrix is not always commutative. We can not say always AB is equal to BA. Sometimes maybe AB is equal to BA, but this is not necessarily equal. That is, if AB equal to BA, we say A and B both will be commutative. Otherwise, no. This is fourth property. Next, fifth property is if AB is equal to 0, if AB is equal to 0, then it doesn't mean A equal to 0 or B is equal to 0. Means here A and B both have to be equal to 0, then the product of these matrix will be 0 matrix, means null matrix. Okay. Next, sixth property is if AB is equal to AC and BC is equal to CD. Okay, first we will take AB equal to AC. It doesn't mean we can say here by cancelling A and A means A, B and C equal to C. No, we can't say like this. Or if BC equal to CA, if we cancel C by C, then we say AB is equal to A. No, we can't say like this. AB equal to AC and BC equal to C doesn't necessarily mean B equal to C. Doesn't necessarily mean B equal to C. Okay. That is cancellation law. Do not hold here in the property. It is the property of matrix multiplication. Next, if AO equal to OA. Look at here. O means null matrix. Zero matrix here. If A matrix, some A matrix, when you multiply this A matrix by the 0 matrix, then it will equal to 0 matrix to A matrix multiplication is equal to totally equal to null matrix. Means when we multiply any matrix to the 0 matrix, then the resulting matrix will be 0. Again, null matrix here. Next, A property is when we multiply any A matrix by the identity matrix, then this is equal to A multiply I, or this is equal to the that resulting A matrix. Okay, where A is the unit matrix. So we have completed the properties of matrix multiplication. Okay, I hope you will all clear that. Thank you.